As we hit the slowdown period on the first day of the free agency frenzy, and it really was a frenzy, with a number of guys signing shortly after the market opened at noon Eastern today, we get a chance to take some stock in what's been done so far and sort of look at the hits and the misses. It's hard to call them misses right now, though, because of the fact that you still have to see how these guys fit in. But the hits are the ones I really like, the short-term contracts. So I'm looking at Brian Campbell going to the Chicago Blackhawks, one-year deal. I think Brian Campbell fits the need that the Chicago Blackhawks had. He's a top four defenseman still. He can skate. They need him. He will fit in there. He already has, and he's won a cup there. Dan Hamhuis with the Dallas Stars on a two-year contract. I like that one, too. He plays a lot of minutes, and the coach doesn't have to worry about him, and they know each other, too. Hamhuis did play for Lindy Ruff's defense at the Olympics, too. Didn't play a lot, but he'll play a lot more in Dallas. And I like the Eric Staal contract. I'm not 100% sure that Eric Staal is a number one center. He might have to be in Minnesota, but I still think he's got a lot of good hockey left in him. And on a three-year deal, he'll be motivated, and it's a team where he's got a defined role. He never really had that after he got traded to the New York Rangers. The one short-term deal that does raise my eyebrows a little bit is the Alexander Radulov deal. 1 year, $5.75 million to the Montreal Canadiens. Gonna have to see how that one plays out before we can label it either way. The long-term ones are the ones that, you know, raise my eyebrows a little bit. Milan Lucic on a 7-year deal, $42 million. He plays a hard, heavy game. How's Lucic going to look in year 5, 6, and 7 of this contract? You have to think about that as well. Kyle Okposo, another one, 7-year deal, $42 million. I like Okposo. I always envision him as more of a second-line guy, a second-line right wing who can score. It's a lot of money and a lot of term for Kyle Okposo. Maybe he can live up to it, though, if he plays with Jack Eichel. And Louis Erickson, it's not so much Louis Erickson on a 6-year contract with the Vancouver Canucks. It's a question of what are the Vancouver Canucks doing right now. They seem to be a team caught in between with a number of guys who are 30-plus and a number of guys who might not be ready for the prime time just yet. They don't have that middle-tier guy. Not 100% sure what they're doing there right now in Vancouver. Do they want to build for a championship team, or do they want to rebuild to get a championship team? I think they're caught in between. But without question, to me, the team that won the day today and really has won the week is the Tampa Bay Lightning. And they didn't even do anything. They didn't even sign an unrestricted free agent. They didn't hit the market. What they did was a couple days ago, they got Steven Stamkos back on an 8-year deal, $8.5 million. And today they get Victor Hedman to sign an 8-year deal, $63 million total. To have Stamkos and Hedman signed at a total cap hit of $16.375 million from 2017 through 2024 is a huge coup for the Tampa Bay Lightning. It allowed them to re-sign Andre Vasilevsky to a contract extension, $3.5 million per for 3 years starting 2017. And it also will likely allow them to get Nikita Kucherov under contract and figure out what they do after that with Palat and Johnson and Drouin. Steve Yzerman knows what he's doing there. He's got his team in place. They're a contender. For me, they're the big winner. But there are other teams out there that have done some things that I like and done some things that sort of raise my eyebrows a little bit.